We got Max in a second. Matt, why don't you come up here? So, the timer's on. You have 300 seconds at the most. At the most. 300 seconds, you know how much that is? 5 minutes.
Yes.
So, I faced a lot of rejection, really, depression for years and years, unaccepted. Then God gave me a revelation. I am a son. I am a child of God, really. So I got delivered for like 6 months, knowing that I don't care what anyone else says. I said in the word of what God says. I went through counseling with Josh and Greg, really go through my childhood life, how really my mind was working. And yet, depression breaks. The more you read the Word of God, it says, renew your mind. Really, I am healed.
Yeah.
So, doesn't matter what that person says about you, if you're facing like depression, God's there for you. Mm-hmm. You just need to read it, you need to know it, to believe it. And you need to have that in your heart. Or it's going to destroy your life. You're going to get angry, you're going to get depressed, you're going to worry. Now, don't worry about anything else. If I do worry, then God, I give it to you. Mm-hmm. That's all I just felt to share, man.
That's awesome. Very cool. Well, Jesus said in John chapter 8, he said, you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free.
Yeah.
So, what keeps us in bondage are lies that we believe, either about God, about ourselves. You know, if you believe that, you know, if you believe a lie, that lie is going to reap fruit in your life. It's like a root that's sucking poison into your life. And so Matt believed a bunch of lies, and we pinpointed them. And then I said, find the truth. Find 10 scriptures that, or one, or two, or three. Find the truth that will obliterate that lie, and then start believing and confessing the truth over you. So when I was 20, who here has been through some rejection in their life? Everybody here, right? And so I had a core belief, an ungodly belief when I was 20 years old, and the Lord spoke. I didn't even know I had it. He said to me, because it was wrecking my life. I had performance issues. I just, even as a Christian, I thought, I was just trying to get everyone to like me and accept me, and who knows, it's never going to happen. And so the lie I believed, it was everybody. Yeah, I want you to stand up here for Melon Frisian. Everybody rejects me. And I really believe that. Everybody, so I'd always, out of that lie, I'd try to be like, hey, you know, Daryl, I'm such a great pastor. You know, I evangelized 5 times last week, and the Lord did this and that, and he did this through my life. And would you be my friend? Would you validate me as a minister of God? So I was constantly in. And people were like, they could feel the weirdness out of it because it wasn't coming out of my true self. So I was like a weird 20-year-old on fire Christian. That's why some Christians are like, they're really weird. And you sense that there's something off here, because oftentimes they're just acting out of an ungodly belief instead of resting in who they really are. And so you know what? The truth that the Lord spoke to me, when he spoke that to me, everyone rejects me. I cried and cried and cried, and thankfully I was at school of ministry, so I was loud. I cried, and I was actually in Costa Rica on a ministry trip. I sobbed pools and pools of snot and tears. It was disgusting. Like, got it all over this guy. It was gross. But the Lord was healing my heart. The Lord was healing my heart. He was tearing down walls. He showed me this vision. It's a big story. And Matt, he said, well, what's the godly belief? What's the truth? I said, Lord, what's the truth? And the Lord spoke so clearly in my heart. He said, everyone loves you. And if they don't, they're really missing out. And that truth just flooded my heart, and I realized. So now I actually feel sorry for people. I literally do. If they're like, well, you're a weird cult leader, I'm like, oh, man. Sorry for you. I don't care. It doesn't bother me anymore because the truth has set me free. But truth is not an idea. It's not words in a page. It's a person called Jesus who wants to speak to you personally.
Yeah.
And so the Lord spoke a bunch of truth to Matt's heart. And he's, I don't know if you've noticed, some of you have known him a little longer, mm-hmm. he used to get angry.
Yeah.
Just like, scary.
Love you, Matt.
And he's changed. There's a calmness. There's a tranquility about him. There's just a grace about him now. So anyway, so Lord, we just bless Matt. Thank you for his life. Continue to work, Holy Spirit, in this man from glory to glory. Amen. Thanks, man. Very cool. Max, was your hand still up, brother?
I did want to, and then I looked around and I saw all the people, and I changed my mind.
We all love you. I want to hear what you have to say.
I might get you. Okay, you're coming up? All right.
Yeah, come on.
Do you want me to hold the mic, or do you want to hold it?
Oh, my name's Max.
Hi, Max.
Hi, Max.
You're the best.
Okay, well, maybe some of you know or some of you don't. I don't like talking about my problems a lot, but forget about if people knew that I'm like bipolar or whatever. Forget about that. I'm epileptic, and in 2013, I was in the hospital for 2 weeks because I almost died of an epileptic seizure. And my brother and his girlfriend found me in the backyard, like just lying on the ground. Now I really have no other thing to believe in. The reason why I'm here is like God wanted me not to die. Yeah,
that's awesome. If you knew Max before, hold on. You would encounter a pot smoking.
That's still a little bit there, man.
You'd encounter basically someone who's not doing much in life, and not happy, no joy, and the Lord's transformed him.
Yeah.
Now and yeah, there's still some things that we need to work on and give up. But you know, it's lies that we believe.
Fighting a little bit of a uphill battle with you all.
So Lord, we just thank you for Max, and we bless him today, and we just thank you for his life. And thank you for all you're doing in his heart. And take him to the next level.
Yes.
Take him to the next level, we pray.
Yeah.
Max, we bless you, we cover you in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, buddy.
Yo, Kyle.
Kyle.
Hi. I just want to share a bit of my testimony. At a young age, I dealt with some trauma, and I turned my back on God. And about 4 years ago, I went to Brentwood, where Ricky is right now. God bless that place. I found God again. I went to a service. I started weeping at that service, finding God again. And, how far I've came in my life today since I've given my life to God, you know? I was very badly addicted to drugs and alcohol for a long time in my life. I believe I've been delivered from that.
Yeah.
I've been healed from that disease of addiction.
Yeah.
It is gone from my life today. But I've started to tithe. I've been given a great opportunity with work. You know that I've surrendered so much to Jesus, and I've been given so much back in my life today. The people that I have in my life today, I've been given back the relationships with my family that were really broken.
Yeah.
So I've been given all of that back in my life today, and I'm so grateful for everything I've been given. I've decided to go back to school. One of the things that I'm very passionate about is helping people with their recovery.
Yeah.
Through my experience and the strength that I've found, through the hope that I've found, and I'm going to go back to school to be an addiction counselor.
Yeah.
Man, if you knew this guy, even 6 months ago, hey? 6 months ago, he gave his life to Christ, like really gave it. Like there was a journey of finding God, and then he came to church and realized, like, wow, God wants my whole life. It's crazy. And his life has been totally transformed. He's working 6 days a week now, and just a workhorse, and that's just for a season. But it's really cool, really cool. Bless you, man. That's awesome. That's all. Let's pray for you. Father, we just thank you for Kyle. Thank you for his life and all that you're doing in his heart and his life, and we bless him. Amen.
Yeah.
I want to get quickly Michelle to come and share. I was just gonna maybe get power in sharing again.
Yeah.
I know I've heard some of it, but I just want you to share. Do you want me to hold the mic, or do you want to hold it?
If you can, that'd be great. Yeah. Goodness. I guess just growing up, I've never felt loved.
You're loved.
Don't do it.
I know I'm
awesome. Don't do it. I'm crying. So. Just thinking that the only way to get a man's love was to let them control you. I think I remember looking back at my diary when I was a little girl, and not a little girl, but a teenager, and I think I loved every boy I ever met. It was Michelle Loves, Michelle Loves, Michelle Loves, Michelle Loves. I guess I've always felt I wanted to be loved, but I was looking for it in the wrong place.
Yeah.
And then I have two beautiful daughters, and watching them now go, well, the oldest go down the path that I feel like she's living my life all over again. And I just couldn't help her. So I just shut myself down and turned to alcohol to numb the pain. And then I realized that I was trying to do everything to make people like me so I would do what they were doing, and that would make them like me and fit in. So I totally shut myself down and my family. I tried pushing them away because it was easier to push them away than to let them in. And I just wanted to help my family now, especially Alicia, to get her on the right path, because I see how many times her heart's being broken now. And then just realizing that someone came into my life, and I thought that person was showing me love in a different way. But it was just another lie again. So it's just, I guess what I'm trying to say is the only person that loves you is God.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
He's the only one that can give you the love that you want.
Yeah. Yeah.
The love that you deserve.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And through him, I actually got to help my daughter last night.
Yeah.
She was laying on the floor with a broken heart. And she just called up, "Mommy, I need you." And I ran up. And I held her, and I just asked for God to bring her peace. I said that you are the Father of all mercy and the God of all comfort.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like a numbness came entirely over her body within seconds, and she just laid there in total peace.
Yeah.
I thank God for that.
Getting to see Michelle's life and the Lord just taking her in the last 6 months. You got saved 6 months ago. And the Holy Spirit putting back together all the broken pieces.
Yeah.
It's awesome. To see her get baptized in the Holy Spirit, pray in tongues.
Yeah.
Meet the Lord in, like, we prayed at Alvingston. In Alvingston, we said a prayer for her daughter, and we held hands, like four of us held hands and prayed, and to see the Holy Spirit overwhelm her, where she almost like, it's awesome. Awesome. Like, this is what it's about for me. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord will restore. The Lord will restore.
Yes.
God's doing a wonderful thing in Jordan's life. Like, that's my youngest daughter, and he's already been doing work on her. Jamie, my husband,
came to church last week.
Woo! The church last week. And the only thing that kind of threw him off was the healing at the end. He said he enjoyed it till the healing part came. And then I kind of, at first I started arguing with him because I felt, you know, you're talking about my God, our God, you know, and I felt very upset and angry. Like, do you even know who God is? You don't understand. And then I was like, I'm done, I'm going to my room, I'm laying down. And Revelation came, and it was just like, well, because his problem was, there's no healing on YouTube, you don't see it. And what I said to him was, well, it happens, it just, so who's ready with a camera to take this and a video? It just happens.
Yeah.
It's not supposed to be recorded. I don't know if it's supposed to be recorded or not, but that he understood that at that point. Okay, I kind of get it. So he now is reading over my shoulder with things. You know, I see things in the sky a lot, and I'm showing him now, and he's like, oh, I think I see it. I do see it. So God is working on him now.
Yeah.
See, hold on. A nice little service, people can stomach that. But when the healing presence of God comes and people start getting healed, what it does is it draws a line in the sand, and God says, I'm real. And you're not getting away without an answer. I'm real. It's an ultimatum, really. It's a line in the sand, but God says, I'm real, and you have to choose. There's no way out. This is me. It's a miracle, like when miracles happen before people's eyes.
Yeah.
And that's why the Lord, I could send him some videos.
Yeah, I've got a bunch too.
Like, man, there's some powerful ministry, like there's some powerful stuff. I remember when, you know, I was told this story before, when I was in Pakistan, deaf ears from birth opening up, from birth. Young teenage girls who have never heard anything in their life, the Lord just popping their ears open. Awesome. Now, why does that happen? And because number one, the Lord loves them and just wants to heal them. But also, it just shows all the 10,000 Muslim people that were there that this Jesus is real. Allah can't open ears, but Jesus opens ears. Come to Jesus and call on him and be saved from your sin.
Yeah.
And people do. They flock by the thousands because of the miracles. That draws a line in the sand. They're so hungry and they're so ready. With other people, they go, and they just, the wrestling begins. But with just a nice little service, there would be no wrestling. He'd just dismiss it as, okay, this is your nice little thing you're doing. But power draws a line in the sand, and they say, I can't dismiss this. That's why they get mad. So getting mad, actually a good thing.
Yeah.
Good thing for you, Jamie. So, Father, are you good?
Good.
That was powerful.
Yeah.
Father, we thank you for Michelle and Holy Spirit, you're working in her life. You are awesome, and we just thank you. We bless this work that you're doing in her heart and her life. Lord, we cover. I just want to let you know I pray for you almost every day. Actually, every time at morning prayer, you're one of the first people I pray for because the Lord is just, he's working in you.
Yeah.
So I pray that the intimacy, Lord, between Michelle and you, Papa, would grow and that she would fall totally and completely and madly and fully in love with you. Amen. Very cool. Thank you. Okay, we'll do one more, and then we'll Daryl. We might do Luis after, maybe. No, it's good.
There's a real sunshine of love in this place. There's a real anointing, and through the humility of each and everybody here, even walking through that door really felt loved and accepted. And myself, I dealt with a lot of pain through going through a divorce, and spent 3 years in counseling trying to make it work, and I didn't want the best for her, and she's a beautiful person and a good heart, and now I really I want the best for her, and that she has a great life, and it's an anger that I had to probably get through, whatever it is, but a testimony for me is being married to Liz, and I'm so blessed that I'm so blessed to have her. And every day we wake up and we read the word. First thing we do in the morning is read the word, or USB, the daily word of the day, and read the scriptures to go with it, and we start our day that way. And it just gives us, you know, you still sin and you still make mistakes, but you look back and you got that foundation. And it's changing the habit, starting new habits, start your day that way, whether you feel it or not. Through her there's a peace and there's a love there. Yeah. But I really feel here that, man, we got special people here.
Yeah.
And God really loves each and every person here. And it's such a welcoming and a love as soon as you walk in this door. I just want to share that with you guys. And
yeah.
It's a miracle. What you mentioned, Red, there, Rick Wagner. I was in a place last week where the cell phone would not work. I'm out in the middle of the ocean where you can't see land, and my phone kicked in, and it's Red. And he's not allowed to make calls and be on Facebook or sell, you know, talking to people. And I was able to pray with him.
Yeah, wow.
And asked him to accept the Lord into his life. And,
woo!
And
what day was that?
I don't know, honey. When was that? Wednesday or Thursday?
Last Wednesday.
About a week ago. About a week ago.
Wow. We prayed for him last Sunday.
Yeah?
As a congregation.
Wow.
Yeah.
You guys see how mighty prayer is?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Woo. And I haven't been the example to him that I wish I was, you know? But somehow I just loved him. You know, the answer is love.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
And somehow I must have had an effect that he felt whatever. The Lord worked through me, through him, not for me. But anyway, we prayed and we had him over for supper last night, him and Darlene. And it's just a miracle where he's at right now. And just continue to healing over his life and be a better example. But through him too, it's helped us, helped me to realize, gee, where would I be if something happened to Liz or myself? Be prepared for the unexpected. You know, let's have our things together here for the people that love us, that it's not as difficult for them to, if something was to happen. So we were responsible for that. But anyway, I don't want to talk too much. When we talk, we can only share what we know, but when our ears are open, we're able to learn something new from somebody else. And it's really an anointing to be here. I see the Lord really working through you. It's a great ministry you have. And I love the love you have for the people and for Jesus.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's pray for you. Father, we thank you for Daryl. And for I thank you for the calling on his life that has never been more strong than it is right now. And Lord, all that you have for him and what you have for him and his family, his daughters, what you have for his daughters, what you have for him and for Liz, and Lord, the destiny that you have. And I pray, Lord, that any stigma would be, Liz, can you come up? I feel something. Can you just come up here for a minute? Mark as well. Yeah, just grab hands. I don't know, the Lord's just telling me to do this. Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord, I just break off any stigma that's trying to hold them back from their destiny, individually and together, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I believe you want to do something so powerfully, and just day by day, it's out of rest, it's out of his presence, but it's going to be intense and it's going to be fruitful, and I felt like many people are going to come to the Lord through the ministry that you guys have together, in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you. We break that stigma off right now in Jesus' name, and we release fruitfulness, we release your anointing, let multiplication come, and let your kingdom purpose be wrought through their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth right now, Holy Ghost, have your way. Amen.
I'm here today because Brandy invited us to come.
See how powerful inviting somebody can be?